as part of our counterintelligence mission, is investigating the Russian government's efforts to interfere in the 2016 presidential election. And that includes investigating the nature of any links between individuals associated with the Trump campaign and the Russian government, and whether there was any coordination between the campaign and Russia's efforts.
That was a bombshell announcement from the FBI director, James Comey. And on Friday, we learned that former Trump campaign chair Paul Manafort and former advisors Roger Stone and Carter Page said that they would speak to the House Intelligence Committee about the Russia controversies. And we're back now with the panel. Congressman Zeldin, I want to start with you. As a Republican, do you think, in all fairness, that the American people had a right to know before they went to the polls that this investigation of the Trump campaign had been underway for months?
Well, the investigation that was taking place was with regards to there were successful hacks into the Democratic Congressional Campaign Committee, Democratic National Committee, John Podesta's emails. And you know that was the nature.
No. The FBI director said explicitly that it was the Trump camp, any possible connection with the Trump campaign in the Russia.
Right, but I'm just saying the focus of the reason for the investigation, the focus of that investigation was determining those hacks and whether or not, as you're trying to protect the integrity of Election Day itself, and not being able to hack into our systems at State Board of Elections, like that was the purpose for what was going on, right? That was the focus of it. Incidentally, as you are progressing and you start learning more of the facts, the investigation evolves.
Can I help the congressman?
Go for it.
The answer to the question is yes. The American people deserve to know that there was an investigation going on prior to the election.
Did you support Comey's letter 11 days before the election?
Oh, I did not support Comey's letter.
Okay, so you just contradicted yourself.
I did not contradict myself. Okay. But what's good for the goose is good for the gander. And so the fact is, if you want to come out and say that I've been investigating Anthony Weiner and we found these emails on a computer and we're going to go and investigate these emails, that's fine. But the American public also needs to know, because you've said here, Rick Santorum said here, Sarah Huckabee Sanders, Kellyanne Conway, and all have touted this line. You should not vote for someone who's under FBI investigation. Well, what did we find out? That the president of the United States currently is under FBI investigation. Take it for what you want.
What was he under investigation for?
He and his associates and his campaign for collusion with the Russian government in this presidential election.
We don't know.
First
off, there's no evidence of that. And number two, Dan,
with
all due respect,
yes.
Comey was not clear as to when the investigation about Trump's potential collusion began. I think what Lee is saying is that it started out not as an investigation of Trump or any potential collusion. We don't know at what point that investigation turned, and he was not clear about that, and it could have been after the election.
I want to ask about something else related to this that happened that was really remarkable on Capitol Hill today. Congressman Devin Nunes, who's the chairman of the House Intelligence Committee, he had to apologize to Democrats and some of his fellow Republicans for sharing surveillance information with the White House and the public before he did so with members of his own Intelligence Committee. Listen to what John McCain said about that.
I'm calling for the Select Committee or a special committee. No longer does the Congress have credibility to handle this alone, and I don't say that lightly.
He says it lightly all the time, so that doesn't surprise me that John McCain.
Well, what do you think?
I think it should be done by the committees in charge. Do I think Devin Nunes made a good call? No, I don't think he made a good call. I think he should have talked to his committee before he went to the president, and I don't think his responsibility is to the president. And so, but I would say on the other side, Adam Schiff has reminded me of Joe McCarthy. I mean, these rants about all these coincidences of that have, if you string together, obviously show that there's a Russian conspiracy here with the Trump campaign, are absurd on its face, and he is being just as partisan as Devin Nunes is.
I don't think it's partisan when you've got an FBI director saying that there has clearly been Russian interference somehow in our election. We need to have the facts, and Senator McCain is absolutely right. I do believe we need to have an independent commission. I think that what happened last week shows that it's impossible for there not to be political interference in the Intelligence Committee's conducting this investigation. We're in too partisan an environment, and when you're talking about a foreign government like Russia trying to interfere in our election cycles and Lord knows what else, we need an independent investigation.
Congresswoman, did your colleague, Adam Schiff, go too far when he said this week that the Trump-Russia evidence is more than circumstantial?
I don't think that he did. I don't have the information he does because he's not allowed to share it with me. Mm-hmm. But I think he is one of the most steadfast, even men that I know, and he would never say anything that didn't have truth to it. I admire the way that he's conducting this
investigation. No one else has said that there's any evidence
of
that.
But
no
one else. Guy went rushing to the White House to try to protect
no
them
one
politically.
Else, on both sides of the aisle, in the Senate, no one else has said that.
And if Devin Nunes was coming out publicly with evidence and allegations to make the president look bad, then the Democrats would be celebrating. You don't have to come to the committee first. If you want to go to the cameras and say anything negative at all with regards to the president.
But do you wish that as chairman of the Intelligence Committee, which historically has been bipartisan, the last vestige of bipartisanship in Washington, should he have
I agree with everything that Rick just said. Okay. You know, he's absolutely right in his analysis. I just want to point out, though,
real quick,
that how this would have actually played out if Devin was going out with something that makes the president look bad.
Okay, fair enough.
But
thank you all for that great
credibility
discussion
of that committee, period.
We'll leave it there. Thank you, everybody. Appreciate it.